Kim Jong Un prefers to travel in his secret train when going anywhere. This train is not just any train, but a moving fortress, or it can also be called a moving five-star hotel. Although he rarely travels, when he does, he ensures nothing lacks in his grandeur. Officially, the train is named Taeyangho, but the world recognizes it as the moving fortress. Some people even compare the facilities and security system on board to Air Force One, the plane in which the US president travels. So, what exactly is in Kim Jong-un's train? Let's find out the features one by one. Since Kim Jong-un became the president of North Korea, he has only visited a few countries, mainly China and Russia. In the last 13 years, Kim Jong-un has only made 10 international tours, most of which utilized this moving fortress. The train is escorted by two separate trains, one ahead of it, which faces any danger on the route first, such as the presence of explosive bombs on the track or any unusual activity around. Although when President Kim Jong-un travels, no one is allowed to loiter near the track. The commandos inside the leading train keep an eye on every minor detail. The second train follows behind, fully loaded with ammunition and army commandos. Their job is to protect their supreme leader in case of any incident. In addition, a helicopter flies with the convoy as long as the train is within North Korean territory. Should all this force still fall short, cargo planes filled with ammunition and commandos are ready to take off from nearby airports. The mission is only one: to protect the supreme leader at all costs. As for the train, all its windows are made of bulletproof glass. Its roof and bottom are made of reinforced steel, which can protect the carriage from damage even in the event of an explosion. Various kinds of weapons are installed in different compartments of the train, including an anti-aircraft missile system that protects the train from aerial threats. Anti-tank missiles and machine guns are mounted on both sides of the train, so if there's an attack from any side, it can be strongly countered. Even if all this system fails, it does not mean Kim Jong-un's death, because one of the fortress's carriages carries a small helicopter for travel. If such a situation arises, Kim Jong-un would be evacuated in it. All the advanced security systems installed in Kim Jong-un's train make it very safe, but also quite heavy. This is why the train can only travel at a maximum speed of 60 kilometers per hour, and often even less, because the rail tracks in North Korea are in poor condition. Whenever the president's train passes through any station, the lights of the entire station are turned off beforehand. Moreover, to ensure that no other train passes on the adjacent track, its electricity connection is also cut off. So far, 20 such railway stations have been constructed across North Korea, where only Kim Jong-un's train can go. Due to its slow speeds, the North Korean president's train takes several days to reach its destination. For instance, in September 2023, when he went to meet Russian President Vladimir Putin in Russia, it took him 10 days to cover the distance. At the North Korea-Russia border, Kim Jong-un's train is stopped to change its wheels because the railway tracks in Russia are much wider compared to those in North Korea. Talking about the interior of the train, it has all the facilities that one would find in a president's home and office. Kim has his own personal office, which includes a fax machine and satellite phone facility. The train is equipped with a reception room, meeting room, and luxury suites, all of which have wooden flooring. However, the most special feature of this train is its restaurant. Yes, a variety of dishes are prepared at Kim Jong-un's request. Mostly, the menu includes French, Korean, Chinese, and Japanese dishes. During his travels, there's no question of Kim Jong-un getting bored, because in this private train, there are singers and dancers instead of lady conductors who personally entertain their supreme leader. If the train reaches its destination, or if there is an intention to get off somewhere along the way, Kim Jong-un's personal Mercedes limousine is also present on the train with him. These cars can be unloaded and the president can be transported to his desired location under security. Seeing all these things, you might be wondering why Kim Jong-un only travels by train. Actually, traveling by train is a very old tradition of the Kim family. Kim Jong-un's father and grandfather also have a record of going on official trips by train. In Pyongyang, there is the Kumsusan Palace of the Sun, where the preserved dead bodies of Kim Jong-il and Kim Il-sung are kept. These were Kim Jong-un's father and grandfather. Next to their bodies, models of the train carriages they used are also displayed. There, one can see their pictures, in which they are standing next to their trains, and some maps as well, which map out the journeys they made by train. It is said that Kim Jong Il was afraid of flying, which is why he traveled by train. In 2001, Kim Jong Il traveled by train to Moscow, covering a distance of about 20,000 kilometers, which took him about a month. Perhaps this secret train would have remained unknown, but during this trip, a Russian official, Konstantin Pulikovsky, also traveled with him. After their journey, he wrote a book detailing all the services and features of the train. Before this book was published, no one knew what the interior of North Korea's royal train looked like. It was said that the train provided luxurious service, and the restaurant on board had live lobsters and specially imported wine from France. This tradition of traveling by train on official trips has been maintained by the Kim family from the beginning. In 2004, Kim Jong-un's father, Kim Jong-il's train passed through Tungcheong Station, which is located on the border between North Korea and China. After the train passed, a sudden explosion occurred at the station. It turned out that a cargo train carrying oil had caught fire due to a short circuit. However, the Kim family suspected it was a failed assassination attempt. From that day onwards, security for the Kim family's trains was significantly increased. Starting in 2009, Russian photographers were forbidden from taking pictures of the train, even when it was on Russian territory. Not only that, but the route the train took was through Siberia, where the population is already very sparse. Yet, whenever the train had to pass near a village, the entire village's electricity would be cut off. When it comes to Kim Jong-un's enemies, the threat from America and the CIA is well known, but the biggest threat is from the people of North Korea themselves. People are frequently punished for minor things and are sent to hard labor camps just because they didn't cut their hair like Kim Jong-un's hairstyle or were found with a Bible. For these reasons, the local population is Kim Jong-un's biggest enemy. If they show support, it's only out of fear. On several occasions, Kim Jong-un has been seen with lookalikes. For example, at a missile launch event, Kim was seen talking to one of his doubles. These lookalikes are present at major events to confuse any potential shooters about which one is the real Kim Jong-un. Experts believe that besides family tradition, another reason Kim Jong-un prefers traveling by train is to show his people that he travels with simplicity compared to the US President's Air Force One. But in reality, North Koreans don't know everything about this train that you can see in this video because social media does not exist in North Korea. Only North Korea's top officials have access to free internet. In reality, Kim Jong-un leads a very lavish lifestyle. According to satellite images from 2020, he has several mansions where private railway stations are built, and this moving fortress has been seen parked there as well. This luxury resort features multiple villas, a private beach, a shooting range, a basketball court, and a covered garage for parking yachts. Another reason why Kim Jong-un feels so unsafe is the dictatorship in North Korea, where the Kim family has ruled for the past several decades. Now, the problem is that Kim Jong-un is the last heir to the throne, meaning he has no son to take over his position. Kim is well aware that his position is very weak. There are many elites in North Korea who could take over after him, but then it would no longer be the Kim family's reign. Kim Jong-un has a sister, who might attempt to wield power, but Kim believes that if anything happens to him, the military could easily replace him with someone else.